Hello guys, welcome back to Fresher Bee. In today's video, we'll talk about the TCS upcoming placement drive and all the information regarding the selection process of TCS. So before that, I'll tell you about our channel. So in our channel, we provide all the information regarding various government jobs, technical jobs, non-technical jobs, and all the other information like onboarding procedure of various MNCs and selection process of all the companies. So if you haven't yet subscribed to our channel, please do so that you can get all the latest updates regarding these kind of videos. So let's move forward with the today's video, which is about TCS. So as we all know that TCS is set to hire around 40,000 freshers by December 2020. So TCS is one of the Indian multinational IT sector company which also works in consulting services, and this is one of India's most big company that hires the most number of candidates per year. And TCS is headquartered in Mumbai in Maharashtra. So we'll see about all the information regarding TCS upcoming placement drive. So first of all, we'll see information about TCS. So TCS is basically Tata Consultancy Services, which was founded on 1st of April in 1968, and that was founded by Faki Chand Kohli and J.R.D. Tata, and it is owned by Tata Group, and the current CEO of TCS is Rajesh Gopinathan, and the chairman of Tata Group is N. Chandrasekharan. And the total revenue of TCS is around $23 billion, and the total number of employees working there are around 4,48,000 plus. So this is a very huge number of employees working there. Further, we'll see about the exam they conduct to hire candidates, that is TCS NQT. So TCS NQT is like National Qualifier Test, is designed to test the skills and bring on board the best of all the candidates. TCS NQT is a pan India drive beginning with an online test followed by a personal interview, which will have three rounds like technical, managerial and the HR round. Post the assessment, interview date and location will be communicated to candidates individually via their emails. So this is the exam they conduct to filter the candidates who are eligible for the further rounds. So we'll discuss about all the sections or stages they'll conduct in this TCS NQT further in the video. So don't skip the video in between. Watch the video till the end so that you can get an idea of all the stages included in TCS NQT exam. So TCS NQT is basically an online test which includes both aptitude and programming skill test. So total 35% of all the candidates giving that exam are selected for the interview, and out of those 35%, top 35% are considered for the TCS Ninja interview, and the package for Ninja is around 3.5 LPA. And top 10% of the TCS NQT candidates are invited for the TCS digital interview, which holds a package of 6.5 LPA. TCS Ninja and TCS Digital are the two different designations in TCS, and they recruit these two designations through the performance in TCS NQT exam. So we'll see about the selection process of TCS NQT. TCS NQT basically includes total four sections. First will be English test, second will be quantitative aptitude, third will be technical MCQs, and the last one will be coding section. And once you clear all these sections, the next will be technical interview, and after that your managerial interview and HR interview will be conducted. And once you are done with all these stages, your offer letter will be sent to you on your mail. So this is a basic selection process of TCS NQT. So now we'll see about the eligibility criteria for TCS. We'll see one by one all the eligibility criteria they have mentioned for the candidates who are applying to TCS NQT. The very first criteria will be like full-time graduates from BE, BTech, ME, MTech, MSc and MCA are eligible. And they have mentioned like all the engineering streams are allowed. And for MSc, only computer science and IT related streams are eligible for this drive. And a candidate must have a 60% score throughout academics in 10th, 12th and your undergraduation, and if you are a diploma candidate, then in diploma or post-graduation. And next will be the experience should not be more than 3 months. And the backlog criteria they have mentioned here is like one active backlog at the time of appearing of exam is allowed. Like if you are having one backlog, then it's okay, you are still eligible for giving the TCS NQT exam. And the gap criteria they have mentioned here is like overall gap in academic career should not be exceeded than 2 years. So if you are having 2 years of gap, then you are eligible. And I think there is a correction, like not 3 months, not more than 3 years. Experience criteria is not more than 3 years. So further we'll see about the exam pattern, like what are the number of questions they ask in each section. So we'll go one by one. Like the very first section is English section, which will be included 10 questions. And the time limit they are giving here is like 10 minutes. And for con section, there will be 15 questions and the time will be 30 minutes. And in third section, technical, there will be total 12 questions with a time limit of 25 minutes. And in coding section, they'll ask you one question and time they'll provide you is about 55 minutes. So totally there will be 35 questions plus one coding question, and total time limit will be 120 minutes. That is almost 2 hours of time limit. So make the note of one point, that there is negative marking for all the wrong questions, like minus 0.33 marks will be deducted from your total score if you are giving answer wrong to any particular question. So make note that you don't take the wrong answers. So now we'll discuss about the main topics. There are possibilities that they'll ask in the all three sections. We'll go one by one. The very first section is English. That is the main topics are like, I have made a list of all the main topics for English. Sections like sentence completion, articles, prepositions, close passage, direct and indirect speech, and paragemal. So these are the topics. There are possibilities that they can ask you questions on. So practice well on all these topics. Further, we'll see about the topics for the con section. There are various topics, but I have mentioned those topics which are mostly asked. Topics like number system, HCF, LCM, time, speed and distance, mixtures and allegations, time, work and percentages, permutation, combination, profit loss, functions, series and progression, equations, blood relations, algebra, averages, geometry, clocks and calendars. So these are the topics they mostly ask questions on in con section. So practice well for all these topics. So main topics for technical MCQs are related to programming concepts. They can ask you questions on iteration, recursion, procedural versus OOP. And for languages, C language, like call by reference concept, basic and derived data types, storage classes, scope and visibility, basics of pointers, basic header files, library functions, branching and looping, command line arguments, user defined functions. And in algorithms, they can ask you questions on basic search algorithms and basic sort algorithms, questions on tree traversal, dynamic programming, and in data structures, questions on array, stack, queue, list, tree, hash table. So these are the topics they can ask you questions on considering the technical MCQs. So prepare well through all these topics. And lastly, in coding section, they'll give you one coding problem and which is to be solved in 30 minutes. An inbuilt compiler will be provided to solve the questions in any one of the programming languages, and languages like C, CPP, Java, Perl, or Python are allowed. So make sure you are good with any one of the languages mentioned here, and prepare well through all the basic concepts regarding all the sections I have mentioned before in the video, and even focus on the coding section, as this is one of the important section where they'll filter most of the candidates. So this is the complete information regarding TCS. Thank you for watching, and please don't forget to like, share and comment, and please subscribe to FreshOBE for all the latest updates and more videos like this. We'll meet in the next video. Thank you.